Praise the Lord. I want to add in to what Pastor LT just shared. We have many couples who never have a Valentine dinner before. And Friday night is their first one. Their life is so impacted that they request that we will have marriage enrichment seminar offered to the Vietnamese-speaking community, because so many people have been blessed and they learn the love of God. We have people who are able to bring their husband, their wife, who never been in VBC before. They're able to take that opportunity to minister and bring their loved one to the church. And what a blessing. And I want to continue to ask the Lord to bless many of you who have been in the planning committee of that special event, that God will reward you double, triple blessing in your life because you give so much. I saw and been here with you guys up until 1-2 o'clock in the morning, and you still serve without hesitation because you know there is a purpose of everything that we do, and I praise God for your life. Wonderful, wonderful. Well, I want to continue our series on life apps. We have looked at the book of James. You know that James is a brother of our Lord Jesus Christ. And before Jesus died, buried, and resurrected, James not really into the ministry of our Lord Jesus Christ. And there's time that discipline, we know that Mary go on with Joseph and they have sons and daughters. And one time when Jesus served to the point that he don't have time to eat, they come in and they want to stop him and try to bring some sense out of him because they did not see the spiritual side of the ministry of our Lord Jesus Christ, because they did not see it until the approval of God raised Jesus from the dead. And they know that this is not their brothers that they used to know, but this God in a human form, a human body, and totally changed the way that they look at life. And James, the brother of our Lord Jesus Christ, go on to be a key leader of the church in Jerusalem. And we know that this letter he written, many things that is parallel with what our Lord Jesus taught on the Sermon on the Mount. And you can see the parallels of what both of them teach. And today, as we look at another aspect of teaching of James that we can put into application of our life. And I want to share with you in advance that if you receive this and you apply it into your life, your life will be totally transformed. The way that you look at things and the way that you see prayer and the way that you see your prayer answer will totally change the way that you pray in day to come. So pay attention and ask the Holy Spirit to help you open your heart and receive what you're about to hear today. James, last week we have studied that we see there's a purpose in trial and tribulation that we go through in life. There's a purpose. It's build your patience. And when your patience help build that's enduring in your life, then it's get to the point that your life, when the patience is perfect, its work, that you may be perfect and complete, lacking nothing. When you know that trial have a purpose and you embrace it, with the understanding that God wants to teach you something, God wants to help you, and you see is that when you receive it, and you let the benefit work through your life, then your life can be much more enriched and you will have much more things to share and minister to people. And in the middle of that, James say, but you may not have the wisdom to understand and see what really going on behind the trial that you go through. So he said that if you in that middle of test time, you need a wisdom. And when and how you can get that wisdom, he said that we need to come to the Lord and pray. But as we pray, there's key to help us get our prayer answer. And today we will look at how we can pray and we see God answer our prayer. Many will be just instantly the Lord will answer. That's when we catch the key of what we will learn today. Open with me the epistle of James, chapter 1, verse 5 to 8. If any of you lack of wisdom, let him ask of God, who give to all liberally and without reproach, and it will be given to him. Note that it will be given to him. Verse 6. But let him ask in faith, with no doubting. For he who doubts is like the wave of the sea, driven and tossed by the wind. For let not that man suppose that he will receive anything from the Lord. He is a double-minded man, unstable in all his way. Here we see there's many key for us that we, when we recognize, we take the sea, receive it, you will see your prayer get so much answer that will surprise you in day to come. Here we see that you have to pray in faith. There is more than one type of prayer that offer to God. And one of them is the prayer of faith. And today we will look at how our prayer of faith can impact and can bring result. This prayer, once done according to the principle of God had outlined in His Word, the Bible, can accomplish great things for us. Now, in this stage in my life and ministry, I keep being surprised by God how quick He answers our prayer. Tuesday night, one of the Hispanic sisters come to the prayer meeting. She had back problem in pain for years. And as we ministered to her, instantly God healed her. She in tears, she crying, and then she fall into the floor. When she stand up, she dancing, she praising God because she never see prayer answer that quick and that powerful. And we praise God for that. And my brother and sister, in the same way, when you able to get this key that God have laid out for us in His Word, you will get prayer result in the way that it will amaze you, will astound you in day to come. So first thing first, read and reread and commit to memorize all these scripture that I will say to you, especially the first three scripture. Mark chapter 9, verse 23, Jesus said to him, if you can believe, all things are possible to him who believe. See here, Jesus talking to the father of the boy who was demonized. And this father admit that he don't have the faith. And when Jesus correct him and help him, he cry out and say, oh, help my unbelief. He want to be whole in this area and ask the Lord to help him. And Jesus, when he said here in this scripture, we will see that it's already wired into this verse. Powerful thing can happen when we pray. Jesus said to him, if you can believe, all things are possible to him who believe. And so when you pray, when you come to God and you come with a belief, not doubting, but belief, then it's all things will be possible to him who believe. Now, all things in the Greek mean all, everything. It's not mystical. It's not thing that is we hear that you have to work hard to understand. If you can believe, all things nothing are possible to those, to him who believe. And so, believe. Believe is very important. Mark chapter 11, verse 24. Therefore, I say to you, whatever things you ask when you pray, believe that you receive them and you will have them. Again, you see this. Therefore, I say to you, whatever things you ask when you pray, whatever thing you ask when you pray, believe and you receive them, then you will have them. You see, here another key for us is not only believe, but receive it. Receive it as it's already happened. And that is the active faith that we need to have when we come to God in prayer. I read it one more time. Therefore, I say to you, whatever things you ask when you pray, believe that you receive them. Believe that you will receive them, and you will have them. Powerful. Here we see that Jesus' promise is almost like unreal. When you pray, believe, and you receive them, then you will have them. And so many people, when here, they get stuck when they pray. They pray, and then they sit there and they hope. Instead of pray, and then receive them. Pray, and as receive it as they already possess that. They already have that. And so I want to help you overcome that today and able to apply into your life. So you see, when you pray, heaven move. When you pray, the mighty hand of God move. And Jesus tell people of that time the problem that they have. As many people, when they pray and then they sit there and they hope, they pray and then they sit there and begin to doubt about what they just prayed. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1, it says, now faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. Powerful verse here too. That gives us the key for us to get our prayer answered. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for and evidence of things not seen. So when we come to the Lord, and we pray, we have to come with the prayer of faith. Is that a prayer of hope or a prayer of doubt, but pray of faith? Then you will receive what you ask. When we ask in faith and not wavering, then we will receive what we ask for. Now the scripture here that James said that those who have doubting in their heart when they pray, they just like an object were tossed on the surface of the sea. And when the wave is going, that thing just keep tossing one to another. Just like our heart when we pray and in our mind. When we pray with our faith, it's just like, yeah, he will answer. Maybe not. This is too difficult for God. Well, it's nothing impossible for God. Yes, but this may be the exception. And when your mind keeps tossing like that, you will never. God say in his word right here that nothing, that man don't ever think that he will receive anything from God. Now, I know that it's maybe contradict to some of your belief. You say that if you do this and do that, then God will answer your prayer. No, not amount of work that you do, but the faith that you believe in him. This will bring answer into your life. So when you go to God with a problem, you need to come in a way to him with expectantly. You come and you say, God, when I ask you this, I sit here and I expecting to see great things happen. When you pray, you expecting great things will happen. Instead of just pray and then, well, I just live to heaven one prayer and then I walk away. Whatever he wants to do, he have all the power to do it. That is not active faith. Faith needs to be put in God. And when you pray to the point that you expecting, you demand on the anointing and the power of God to move because you trust him and you faith in him. wonderful invitation that God bring us into the place when we pray and believe in our heart. Because it's impossible for those who come to God without faith. God will never please with that. It's almost like you come to God, and when you pray and you have doubt in your heart, it's just like you come and you tell him to say, I don't think you have the power to help me, but I say it anyway. Hopefully, thing will work out. No, my brother and sister, you have to have active faith. You come in, and when you pray, you believe in what you pray, and you're expecting a great thing happen. One way to ensure that you are asking in faith is to find the promise of God's word and apply that to your situation. Meditate on them. When you pray, Pastor Eddie Smith said, like, there's like ammunition. The word of God, the promise of God is like ammunition. When you come and like you have a machine gun, but without ammunition, there's nothing come out. You have to meditate on the scripture and to pray the promise that God gave it to us, so you can pray with expectancy. You come to God expecting great thing will happen. Your prayer will be successful when you pray in faith. The important part of prayer is ask in faith. You have to do the asking. We cannot expect to receive unless we first do the asking. You see, many people, they think about that prayer. I go through that before as a new believer. You know, I may lay in bed and I think about that prayer. Silent prayer. But God command us that we need to speak out loud our prayer. When you pray, there is part that you need to declare, and you need to use your word to declare before God, heaven and earth, and everything in it, that you believe in God and you ask God for it with your word. We should not always remember that divine principle here that God wants us to pray in Jesus' name. When you pray in Jesus' name, your prayer is a very good place that can go direct to heaven. There's many people who have involved in idol worship and involved with spiritism. After they get saved, they share with me wonderful thing about their journey. In particular, this man, he talking about one day when the demon that he served to tell as a fortune teller and do all kind of thing, when he consoled the evil spirit, and say to the point that they begin to torment him. He cannot sleep, always be chased by them, and they want to take his life. That's the devil. When you serve him, he will destroy your life, because nothing the devil up to the good. He just come to steal, kill, and destroy. And so he had this stage, and he said that for years he had to offer food, even sold his soul to the devil in order to gain power, gain access into the second heaven in order to get information from them to talk to the fortune teller, to the people that come to him. But on that stage, when he so tormented by the devil and he know that they about to take his life, he walked by a church and saw a prayer meeting. And in the spirit, he can see this. Christian, they just kneel down, and in the name of Jesus, they pray. Their prayer go direct into the third heaven. It takes years for people out there try to get to the second heaven when they pray. But as Christian, in the name of Jesus, we go direct into heaven right away. We go right into the throne of God and present our case to him, because Jesus has authorized us to use his name as access to the God the Father. And so there's a powerful principle for us here to understand that when we pray in the name of Jesus, our prayer gets heard in heaven, because we have been authorized to use our Lord Jesus Christ's name. Second thing, that when you pray, believe that you receive. This is very important for us to understand. Mark chapter 11, verse 24. So therefore I say unto you, What thing soever you desire, when you pray, believe that you receive them and you shall have them. It's another version there in the King James Version. They say, when we come to the Lord and we pray, whatever we desire when we pray, believe that we receive it already. What is receive when we pray mean? You know, our physical senses cannot conceive or seeing something unless it's physically before us. But not so with the prayer of faith. After you have brought your request before God, remind Him of His word that you already receive what you have asked for. We must believe that we receive them when we pray. This is the key to pray effectively. Receive is mean to come into possession of. When we pray, we grab a hold of that prayer answer and you receive it just like it's already there. In my practice of this prayer, and this prayer of faith, when I pray for someone, for their healing, when I pray for something, and I got the confirmation in my heart from the Lord that I have it, so I receive it right away. When you receive a gift, what you do? You give thanks. So I give thanks before my eyes can see the prayer answer. Why? Because in the spirit, I already receive it. I already possess it. That's how you pray. When you pray and you ask the Lord for things according to His will, you know that you already have that prayer answer. And just like that, many times, my brother and sister, I see prayer answers come so quick. Like on Tuesday night when I asked Elias, when I pray for her, and they say, so how is your pain? She just stand there, say nothing, and tears begin to stream down her face. And I asked her again, what's going on? And she decided that the pain is gone. It will touch her and heal her. That's a powerful picture for us to see that when you pray, you receive it already in your spirit, and you give thanks in advance because you know that it will happen. It's not if it's happened or you hope it will happen, but you receive it like you come into possession of that prayer answer already. Many people pray and then they sit around, they hope it will happen. Or in a way that many people, it shows like they have faith in God, but actually their faith is not active faith. Many people, when I pray for them, especially they're not here at VBC, when I travel and pray for people in the traditional church, this is how they receive prayer. And then they walk off. When they walk off, and say, where are you going? They say, Pastor, I already believe that I have what I receive. And say, did you check? Has God answered your prayer? And say, that's okay. I don't have to see it because I know that God will answer somehow, some way. That's not active faith. I used to stop them and say, come back here and let me finish our ministry time. And I pray for them the second time, pray for them the third time, and then it's happened when they receive the complete healing. In the same way, my brother and sister, when you pray, your faith has to be active. It's not just pray and then sit around and hope. And nothing come to pass. And then when that series of a prayer like that has happened, you lose faith in God. They will say, I don't know, I pray a lot and nothing has happened because you pray in the wrong way. You pray without faith. And just like James said here, that you like that man have doubting in his heart when he pray. He toss around. He have double mind and double spirit because there's two spirits is going on in his, inside of him. Believe, don't believe. Believe, don't believe. When we're able to get our spirit into the place that we can receive the prayer, receive the answer of that prayer, and you will have something is going on inside of you that you know that you know that you know that the answer has already happened. And we can see that it's applicable to many people. Let me give you an example, and you see. A couple, they love each other so much after they get married for a while. And they love each other so much, they say, let's have children. Okay? And then 3 months later, his wife conceived. And then 6 months later, the baby born. The question I want to ask you is when they have that baby. They say, of course, Pastor, when the conception has happened. No, it's happened when they talk to each other and they say, let's have children. Because that set everything in motion. You see, conception is just the confirmation of what they already hope for, they desire for. And same thing, when we come to God and we say, Lord, I want to receive this. I pray this. I need this wisdom. And when you pray in faith, that has already happened. You already have that wisdom. It's when it manifests later as a confirmation, but it's happened the day, the time that you ask. I've been through the teaching for our small group. Remember Daniel, when he know that 70 years of exile already up. Concerned his people, he began to pray, fast and pray for the future of his people. 21 years, days later, when Gabriel appeared to him and told him thing that he had not seen before, that the first day when he prayed, God already sent prayer answer. And Gabriel bring that answer, and on his way was stopped by the prince of Persia. This is talking about the spirit, the demon that is have been assigned by the devil come to control that kingdom, Persia. 21 days. But when Gabriel able to get to Daniel, he unveiled things and he said, the first day when you pray, God already heard your prayer. You see that it's happened the time that when we pray, we receive it in our spirit and we know that this will happen. When your faith is active like that, when you pray, things will happen for you. We must believe that we receive the thing or answer that we are praying for when we pray. Now, that is faith that you need to have. When you pray, when we pray, we already receive it in our spirit. It's not pray and then sit there and waiting and waiting. Maybe 10 years later it will happen. You receive it right away. Now the answer, when it's manifest, physically manifest to your eyes and you can see and you can receive it, it may have some hindrance. But when you pray, you already receive from the Father and you know that He will bring it to fulfillment in your life. And that is what God is looking for when we pray. Isaiah 43, verse 26 says, let us contend together, state your case, that you may be acquitted. And so you see here that God wants us, when you present our case, when you present it in the way that God has instructed us, you can receive your prayer answer right away. Hebrews 11, chapter 1. Chapter 11, verse 1. It says, now faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. Now, this is a powerful verse for us to understand. We don't have time to break down into the detail of this verse. But here you see that faith is a substance. Faith is not something, a concept. But faith is something that is tangible. Faith has to be active. Faith has something that is we need to have and possess it, receive it in our spirit. So when we have that substance, and that substance when you study in detail is something that is a mass, something that is occupied space, something that is that substance can be the seed of thing will manifest and grow and mature. Bring into fruition of what you have prayed for. So faith is the substance of things that hope for. And so when you pray, faith is the seed. Faith is the mass that will help you see your prayer answer. Faith will help you on that. When I grow up, my grandfather have taxi boat that bring people from city to another on Mekong River. I remember when I was young, my father used to run that business for my grandfather. When I go into the dock and look into the distance, at the corner of one of the islands, when I saw begin with smoke come up, I know that there is something is coming. And then I saw the muffler and the smoke going up. The next thing you know, I saw the top of the cabin, because we know that the earth is rounded. And when you see, first thing you see the tall thing. But when I saw that smoke, I know that Father is coming home. I know that his boat is on its way. I did not see the whole boat yet, but I know that that smoke wind is coming, and then the muffler. Next thing, I have no doubt in my heart that this will appear. So that's the same thing with faith. When you look to God and when you pray, you have that substance for the thing that you hope for, the thing that you not see yet, but you have already confirmation in your spirit that this will happen. That's how you pray. When you pray in the distance, you will see that it's coming your way. And faith is the substance for us to have the things that you hope for and the evidence of things that is not seen yet. But it's come and it's on its way. So true hope is important to have. But it's not enough when you pray. It's something else that you need to have. Faith say that I have it now regardless of whether I see it or not. So you have to have that faith in your heart when you pray and you get your prayer answer. It's a powerful thing that we need to have in our life as we pray, and we receive our prayer answer in a profound way. A third thing we want to look at it is something the prayer of faith can do. There's many things that you can put into application in your life. You know, when we pray, a lot of people, they have asked me and say, Pastor, how come I pray and not much happened? But I heard you share story after story that God answered your prayer. And here is a key that I want to share with you, that you need to apply it into different aspects of your life. Let's look at some of the things that the prayer of faith can do. In Matthew chapter 17, verse 20, it said, if you have faith as a grain of mustard seed, nothing shall be impossible unto you. Now again, hear that Jesus wants to bring things that we can see, ordinary things, to convey a spiritual message. He said, if your faith is just even it's as small as a grain of mustard seed, now that is enough to see that nothing is impossible for the one who have possess of the small seed like that, like the mustard seed. Now, just imagine if you have a seed a little bigger, then you see that it's more assured that your prayer will be answered. But faith is not something that you can measure or weigh. Here, he wants to see that the power packed inside that seed, even though it's small, but it's proportionally when it's grow, the mustard seed, when it's grow into the mustard, you will see that it's proportionally is huge. Reinhard Bonnke put it this way, faith is like that fuse that is connect the wire so the electricity can go through. Faith is like that connection, like that fuse. When you connect it, I look at it this way. When I pray for someone, I'm the fuse to connect the power of God to the people who need prayer. And when that power flow through, things will happen. So when you pray in faith, your faith is just like the fuse that is connected. When that fuse is burned, disconnected, nothing will happen. So one hand, you wrap God in prayer. And one hand, and on the other hand, you wrap the people who have problems or have needs in their life. And when that is connected to your faith, the power of God can flow and meet, satisfy the need that people face in their life. Now look at first thing we see that When we pray, we can see that our prayer of faith can do is bring us divine healing. Divine healing. There's conventional healing. When people take medicine, they need the help of a hospital, doctor, and so on. Conventional medicine, God has blessed people with the mind to understand the principle that He already put in place. You know, medicine many times is abstract from the plan, from whatever have that substance enabled to speed up the process of healing. So God have blessed people with the mind, they able to discover these medicine in terms of raw material and able to condense it and instill it to the small capsule that you can drink. Doctor, God have placed in the structure of our body thing that is it need to work in certain way in order for the body to be healthy and function in a good way. When that process interrupt, doctor can help us. They are very good in cut and sew, but heal or not, it belongs to the Lord. And so the power of healing can come through another mean, is divine healing. Look at James chapter 5, verse 15, said, "And the prayer of faith will save the sick, and the Lord will raise him up, and if he has committed sin, he will be forgiven." We will spend time and study that a little bit more later. But here we see that, and the prayer of faith, what will happen? Will save the sick. And so there is divine healing can come by the prayer of faith. So the prayer of faith will save the sick, and the Lord will raise him up. And if he had committed sin, he will be forgiven. And we see here that the first benefit that we can see it. The second thing is bring us wisdom. How many of us still need wisdom? The prayer of faith can bring more wisdom into your life. James chapter 1, verse 5 and 6 said, "If any of you lack of wisdom, let him ask of God, who give to all liberally and without reproach." God will not say, "Why you don't get it?" He will not reproach you, but he will come and say, "Here," because God wants his children, wants his people not act foolishly, but walk in wisdom. And the fear of the Lord is the beginning of the wisdom. So you come and you pray, and your prayer of faith can bring wisdom in your life. Every day, I pray for wisdom because there's much more in God that we can understand, and we can obtain this wisdom from God in order to minister to people. You know, 30 years of ministry, going 31, I hear so much. There is nothing that is new, but the thing that is come in different way. And when I hear that, and people ask me to pray for and minister to them, I know that true experience is not enough, but the wisdom of God. And so when I pray and ask God to give me the wisdom to help them, praise God that many lives have been helped. Thing that is flow from the throne of grace, that when I give it to people, I later on have to write it down because it's so profound. It's come from God. So when you come and pray in faith, it can bring wisdom into your life. Verse 6, "But let him ask in faith and not doubting, for he who doubts is like a wave of the sea driven and tossed by the wind." So when you pray in faith, you can obtain wisdom. The third thing is bring salvation. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 8 and 9. It says, "For by grace you have been saved through faith. And that not of yourself, is a gift of God, not of work, lest anyone should boast." And we see here that this wonderful principle for us here, that when you pray the prayer of faith, you can receive salvation. When you put your trust in the Lord Jesus Christ, it's not by your work. You see, all the religion, they said you have to work this and work that in order for you to work your way in. And hopefully, when you die, you have enough to obtain salvation. But Christianity is different. That's why it's good news, that by faith, you come and receive that grace, unmerited grace, favor that God give it to you. And when you're able to receive it by faith, the scripture tells us that you are saved, not because of your work, but because of the grace of God. And you, through faith, that you receive it for your life and the life of people around you, your loved one. When you understand this principle and you pray for them and you pray for yourself, that's the beginning of your salvation. This can bring us help from God. 2 Chronicles chapter 20, verse 4. There was a this time when Judah gathered together and asked help from the Lord because they faced the war that they know that they outnumber. And so they asked the Lord for help. And from all the city of Judah, they came to seek the Lord. And so you can apply this, and by you pray and bring the help from God into your life and your situation. And I can tell you that live long enough, I see the hand of God come and help just on time, many times. The one that is so powerful and impact my life till today is God answer my prayer to spare my life by sending rain down into our boat right in the middle of South China Sea and around maybe 100 feet on the left, the right, the front, and the back of the boat. There is nothing. But it's just right, a bucket of water poured out from heaven right on our boat, and it spared 140-some of us on that boat. God answered just like that. He answered while we see there's no cloud and dark skies around us. Right on the top of our boat, right in the middle of the ocean, the water is catching, pouring down on our life and our boat, and it saved our life. We can pray and see help from God. There's many times we witness this. I don't know, maybe I have a witness in this gathering that you can see that God answered our prayer in a way that we don't know how it's happened. There's one time my whole family with me in a minivan. And when I come up to the Bellway 8, ready to get into 45, right in front of us, two car collide. Smoke, dust, everything is blowing up. On the left, I cannot go to the left. The right, I cannot go to the right. There's only one way because it's so quick and so short. Go just like that, and I call out and say, God help. Next thing I know is our minivan past that accident scene. It's just like God just picked it up and put it way past the accident. Last year, after I come back from Nha Ca Winter Retreat, minister here in the church, and in the brand new Camry that we just have, I have my wife with me. We sit and we pray before we leave our parking lot here. Say, Lord, bring us safely to Forest Glen, that we can see our people and minister to them later. And as we get on 45, right where Europe edges, we have four cars. Suddenly, one is lost control, veer over the one right in front of us, hit that car, spin around, hit two cars on the left. You can see the thing is going on, bang, noise going on, dust flying in the air, and pieces of the car is just flying there, and we just go right through it. And somehow, I'm not moved to the left nor the right. And we're able to go through just like that, saved by the hair. We go right through it. I know that God can send help like that. Many report that when they see the 18-wheeler in front of them, oh, they stop and they will go under that truck bed. But some reason, when they open their eyes, it's already there on the next lane and nothing happened. I believe that God can send help when we pray and we ask Him. He will do the miracle to take us out of that. Joel brother Andy, some of you know that his car is spinning on the freeway and flipped. But he walked away, no scratch. Powerful, powerful thing that we will see that God can send help when we pray in faith. This can bring the fullness of joy in our life. John chapter 16, verse 24 says, "Until now, you have asked nothing in my name. Ask, and you will receive, that your joy may be full." When Jesus talked to his disciples at this time, you know, on this year, the children of Israel, when they pray to God, they pray to the God of Abraham, of Isaac, of Jacob. Okay, that's how God revealed to them. And so the people in the Old Testament pray to the God of Abraham, of Isaac, of Jacob. But on that day, Jesus, up until now, you never asked in my name. And he said, until now, you have asked nothing in my name. And then he authorized them and said, ask and you will receive, that your joy may be full. And so when you pray in faith, it will increase the joy in your life because your joy will be full because when you pray, you see God answer. Now, when you pray with a lot of doubt, then there's no joy because your prayer is not answered. And so when you increase with the understand and commit to memorize these verse and principle into your life, you pray, you will see prayer answer over and over and over again. You know, the best thing that has happened for me almost every day in our ministry is when I pray for someone and God healed them right away. People say, oh, Pastor, thank you, thank you. And I told them and say, thank you for allowing me have opportunity to stand there, agree with you and pray and see God answer our prayer quickly like that. God bless me. And the joy of the Lord is filled my heart because I know that he just one prayer away. No problem is too hard for God. He just one prayer away, but a prayer of faith, then you will see he just right there answer and you can experience God in that way. And so I encourage you to increase your faith and make it active faith in the Lord and take every opportunity you can to minister to people. Don't let the devil say things like, oh, those who in Jesus' name, you know, do healing and miracle and still go to hell. That is the people who don't know God, right? They do it in the wrong way. But if you do it in the right way, the joy of the Lord will fill your heart. Because his words say that. In his name, when you pray, then you will see. Things will happen. Ask and you will receive, that your joy may be full. My activity in the day, you can see it. I receive sometimes hundreds of phone calls a day. The phone ring, people ask, Pastor, can you pray for this and can you pray for that? And just like that, I say, yes, Lord, help me. And when we minister to people and he just confirmed the message, he just confirmed prayer of faith and people get healed. And I was so blessed by it and full of joy many times when I walk away, know that God is just a prayer away from us and things will help. And so my brothers, increase the activity of your faith. It's not just sit there, pray and doubt, pray and then hope, but pray with faith so it will bring fullness of joy in your life. It's bring us the Holy Spirit, the baptism of the Holy Spirit. In Galatians chapter 3, verse 2 said, this only I want to learn from you. Did you receive the Spirit by the work of the law or by the hearing of faith? You see, many people, they say, oh, we have to, you know, do things according to the Bible, and they keep the letter of the law. But when you understand the Word of God, and by faith you receive it by hearing, Faith comes by hearing, and the more you hear the word of God that speak to you, as you read, as you study, as you hear the word of God teaching you, faith begins to build in your life. Tuesday, I have a conversation with a sister in our church, Sister Phương Anh. He said there is a worker from pastor near my church in Vietnam just report to her. Wonderful thing has happened. This lady have a stroke and she paralyzed for more than 5 years. And a sister in the church collect the sermon here and able to get the group of CD that is applicable to this lady condition. Bring the sermon to her and begin to play that sermon. And while she listened to that sermon, faith began to build inside of her. Faith began to build, just like that woman with issue of blood. Build in her. Next thing, she began to move around, sit up, and walk. Her family just go crazy. They say, whoa, what's going on here? What happened? The word, coupled with faith and anointing of God, have raised that sister up. Because faith comes by hearing. So here Paul asked the Galatian church. He said, this only I want to learn from you. Did you receive the Spirit by the work of the law or by the hearing of faith? And you know the answer, by the hearing of faith. Luke chapter 11, verse 13. We see here that Jesus, after he used the parable of someone suddenly have someone come and visit him at night. And God have give the children of Israel this hospitality principle that when a stranger, a sojourner, go through a town and come and show up at your door, you are responsible to feed him or her. And so here Jesus used that principle. And he gave it to the people of that time, his disciple and the crowd that time, this principle. He said, a man who come and knock on this door, because the house is, and he know that there's bread in that house, because a friend come and visit him at night, he have nothing to feed that man. So he knock on the door to receive bread, to go back and feed the person who just visited him. Now the man in the house say, go away. We already sleep. Our children already in bed. We cannot give to you. But because this man persistent, Jesus said that the owner of the house will wake up, will light up his light, and he will give him enough bread to feed his friend. And then Jesus go on and he say, ask and you will receive. And he'll go on and he'll say, look at this. If you know good parent, you know how to good gifts to your children. When they ask for bread, you will never toss them a piece of rock. When they ask for fish to go with the bread, you will not give them scorpion or snake. And say, if you are imperfect and you know how to give good gifts to your children, Then here is a comparison to Jesus, that your heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to those who ask him. And so when you pray in faith, you can receive the Holy Spirit's baptism, the power of God, the bread from heaven, that you can minister to people out of that abundance. You know, opportunity will knock on our door many times this year. At the beginning of the year, you remember we have a word from the Lord that there will be double doors of opportunity will open for us. And God will use our life. But we need to recognize that when people come with all of their needs, we don't have the bread to feed them. But there's a house filled with bread. It's God. We can come and ask him, and God will fill our life. Give us what we needed to minister to people. And that's the power and the anointing of the Holy Spirit. When you pray in faith, you will able to receive the blessing of God and be a blessing to other people. Another benefit, blessing that prayer of faith can do with you is move mountain out of your way. Mark chapter 11, verse 23. For as surely I say to you, whoever say to the mountain, be removed and be cast into the sea, and does not doubt in his heart, but believe that those things he say will be done, he will have whatever he say. Do you see that? What a powerful principle here. Let me see here. Let's hear it again. For as surely I say to you, whoever say to this mountain, be removed and be cast into the sea, and does not doubt in his heart, but believe that those things he say will be done, he will have whatever he say. The power of the word that we confess out of the faith that we have in God. Of course, here that God will not tell us to go and see the mountain that God has created beautifully and set it there and say, move, and you mess up God's creation. What I believe that God say here is, there is mountain of obstacle in our way. But by faith and the declaration of the word of our mouth, we can move mountain. We can move things out of our way so we can go on and continue to be a blessing to other people by commanded with faith. So here's another thing that we need to pay attention to, what word come out from our mouth. Because according to your word, here is very powerful. So we're going to say that this is how God create us in his image. When God creates heaven and earth, he spoke and is coming to existence. And we carry this image of God in our life. When we redeem, when we authorize, you know that our word is very powerful. So when you speak into people's life, when you speak into situation, speak in a positive, creative word instead of tear down and destroy. Because your word impact your environment. Very important. As a husband, a father of the family, you need to speak word of affirmation, you speak word of creative word into your family instead of saying things sarcastically, destroy your family. As a wife, don't tear down your marriage by saying word that is tear your husband down, but build him up with word of affirmation. Very powerful, our word. My brother and sister, when I minister to people, you hear me minister before, I speak into that organ. I speak into that leg. I speak into that sickness with the word of command. And many times you see is obey, because the word coupled with faith, authorized by God, will move mountain. When I see that sickness in my mind, in my spirit, I see it as a mountain need to be moved. And when I command it, I receive, I possess it before it's happened. And when it's happened, we know that our prayer of faith bring answer. Healing to people, move mountain out of our way so we can move, go on. The thing that I speak into existence, because God had empowered and authorized me, and he prompted in my spirit to command it. I remember last year, when we take picture of our Christmas card that we send out to our church family here and on to many people so they can know and pray for us. As we all dress up and we go to this location ready to take picture. And I remember Tina say, Pastor, the sun is not out and it's we're not good. The cloud is covered. And I say, let's declare that that cloud will be moved. And collectively as a family, we look into the sky and we say, that cloud needs to be moved. The sun can come out so we can have a good picture. And literally, just like God saying, wind and just blow that cloud, and we will see sun begin to peer through. And we have a beautiful time and the picture has come out beautiful. My brother and sister, there's things that God give us the authority and the power to do. Jesus demonstrated the word of faith when he declared and we talked to the storm and the sea and said, be peace, be still, hush. And the scripture tells us that the storm stopped and the water be still. That's how it's happened. And so my brother and sister here, I try to help you. When I look at the congregation today, it's like, I try to build your faith. I don't know that it's process in your mind or you try to tamper with my faith. But I'm here this morning to help you and say, you need to pray the prayer of faith. If you want to ask God for wisdom or anything from God, you have to pray the prayer of faith instead of doubt. You not pray and then sit around and hope it will happen. But you receive it in your spirit. You receive it because faith, my brother and sister, is an active thing. It's not just a concept or something that you think. It's not just a thought. But faith is something that is action, is a substance, is something that is tangible that you can see when it's take action. And so faith, pray in faith, is very powerful and very important for our life that we need to build this prayer of faith. My challenge to you is go home and take the three scriptures, commit to memorize. I guarantee you, your life, your prayer life will totally change. Many of you heard I share before. Before I get all this understanding and my prayer life transform, it's come to the point that I don't want to hear people come and ask me to pray for them or for their loved one to be healed. Because that time, the more I pray, the more people die. They're not getting their healing. And I don't understand why. My heart is sincere. I pray for them with a prayer that is very sincere, but no faith in there. Because that time I have no understanding because of the training in school and so on. I don't believe that God can heal people or still healing people. And so healing is the past. It's in Jesus' ministry time. But today, God no longer in the business of miracle. So when I pray, even though that my heart is very sincere, but there's no faith in God's power of healing until God take me through the process. And when my faith is perfected in belief in the healing prayer, and praise God, the sin then, many, many people get healed. And I get report all over that people everywhere that God have used our ministry here and our prayer of faith to heal many people. I talked to a brother from Florida, and he said his mother-in-law went to the school of healing that we have in Ho Chi Minh City. And when we minister there, there's a lady pastor from a province from the south. They came up and she received the training. She went home and she began to practice that. She have a faith enough to believe that last stage cancer, God can heal just like that. And it's happened. People get healed. One lady got healed of cancer. She went back and brought her whole village to the church. Because everybody know that she's dying and they already prepared for her funeral. But now she's alive and well and no cancer in her. There's many miracles happened. The church moved from 30-some people. Today they have more than 500. They just finished a building, can sit up to 1,000 people. God still in the business of miracle when we pray the prayer of faith, that he can move mountain out of our way. Matthew 21, verse 21, I want to encourage you to look at this scripture that Jesus said so. Jesus answered and said to him, "As surely I say to you, if you have faith and do not doubt, you will not only do what have done to the fig tree, but also if you say to this mountain, be removed and be cast into the sea, is will be done. This is what styled Peter. The next day, after Jesus talked to the fig tree and he said, from now on, nobody will eat your fruit. And it's happened just like that. The next day, they go by and they say, the tree have withered and died. And so they ask Jesus, and Jesus gave them the key. He took this Kodak moment, and he began to explain to them that if they have faith, they can speak to mountain, they can speak to that, just like that fig tree. Last week we have this wonderful praise report right after I prayed for this lady from New York. Her sister have a stroke and cannot speak normal. Her tongue is messed up and so on. We're able to pray for her and the sister get healed. So she come in and on the phone and asked me, the pastor, there's a thing that is grow in my neck, and the bone is grow and is create a lot of pain. Can you pray for me? And then pray for her. The pain is gone. She feel and she said that grow in her neck bone, her vertebrae, is disappear. And then she said she have another problem on her thigh. There's a grow that when she touches, it's very tender and it's hurt really bad. And she say, can you pray? And will God heal and take away this cyst in my thigh? And I say, why not? Let's pray. We pray. And this is what I apply. I say, Lord, in the name of Jesus, I speak to this growth, this cyst in this lady's thighs, and I say, wither and die until today. Nobody and no one, even the sister, will mention or talk about you anymore. Wither and die in Jesus' name. And I ask her to check it. She feels and say, well, it's used to be my thumb side, but now it's like the grain of rice. And say, that's good, it's withered. And I say, do you have faith to believe that God will totally remove it? She said, yeah, Pastor, it's already subside. And I say, okay, one more time. We command, we say, you cannot be stubborn anymore. This grow totally disappear, wither and die and disappear from her thigh in Jesus' name. And I say, now feel it again. And she feel, and for a while, he said, it's gone, it's gone, it's gone. Praise God. You see, prayer of faith can bring results just like that. Anything else that we need, we can come to the Lord in prayer. Gospel of John chapter 14, verse 14 said, if you ask anything in my name, I will do it. Anything. Of course, you will not go out and say, God, I want 7 Ron Roy, 1 for Monday and the rest of the week. That's not what God will answer. But to pray, here's another principle that you can jot down and put in place. When you pray something, you ask 3 questions. Will this glorify God? Will this help me? And will this help people around me when God answers? And when you filter it through that 3 questions, your prayer or the motive of your prayer is different. It's not like, God, I want to become a billionaire today. Send from heaven. I speak into existence. God not work that way. For what? Now, if you desire to have a lot of wealth to support the message of the gospel go throughout the world, then my brother and sister, rest assured that God will bless you when he can trust you. So ask those 3 questions. Will this glorify God? Will this help me or build me up? Will this minister and help people around me? Is this good for people around me? And when you have 3 answers, it's a yes and all light up, my brother and sister, your prayer answer is on its way. Receive it, possess it, so God can use you and be a blessing for thousands of people. The prayer of faith, the application here that you can apply into different aspects of your life that you can see pray happen in your life. Pray with active faith, my brothers and sisters, will bring result. You can have result right away when you fulfill what the Word of God speaks to us today. So let's receive it by faith. I say, God, today I want my prayer life will be improved, that I will see great things happen when I pray. I see mountain move. I see healing take place. I will see blessing from heaven pour out so I can be a blessing to other people. You can pray and ask the Lord, if though you're here and you want to receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit, the filling of the Holy Spirit, and you pray and you pray and nothing happened, I believe that today something clicked in your spirit. And you can receive it today because you know now that when you come to God, you pray with a prayer of faith. It's not doubting in your heart. It's not tossed like an object on the surface of the sea. But you believe and you receive and you like you already possess that prayer answer. When you come, you will receive it today. I strongly believe that. And I know that God is about to do some great thing in our church. He prepared and He's looking for people who are willing to believe Him for great things. So if you're here today and you need whatever that is it challenge you, you need help, you need a touch from God, you need help. And for the person who have a nightmare last night, in the dream you have, you feel like people chasing you and want to take your life, like Pastor LT received from the Lord this morning. I believe that that person is in the room today. Let come before the Lord and let us pray with you. This can be God allow that happen and give you that dream to prepare you or to help you deal with the thing that is creeping fear in your life right now. So come before Him and receive it. Thank you, Lord. Respond to the message today. Let's come to the altar and ask the Lord. For those of you, your prayer life is not take off, then come before the Lord right now and say, Lord, I ask that you will give me that supernatural faith. I want to see my prayer answered because so many things is on the line. And many things is at stake and I need to have that level of faith. I want to see my prayer will be answered in a way proportioned with your word. And I want to see it happen in my life. If that is you, then come before the Lord today and ask. And we will stand with you in agreement and pray with you. Amen. Those who need ministry, by Pastor Lum have called out, then come and let the Lord minister to you today too. Father, we thank you for an open invitation that you give to us. You want to answer our prayer. You want to give us wisdom. You want to heal us and the people that we care for. We want to receive help from you. And so, Father, thank you for open door for us and invite us in. We take this invitation and we ask that, Lord, give your people the understanding and the faith that they need so their prayer can be answered and their life can be transformed. Come, minister to your people. And Lord, for those who need a filling of the Holy Spirit for the first time, the baptism of the Holy Spirit, I ask that you will give it to them today, Lord, because their faith has been built through your word. We ask that you come and minister to people today. Thank you, Lord. Rochelle, do you have...